So Dr. Mallikarjun actually has been having internet connections, connectivity issues, and has requested me to summarize. So essentially, this today's talk was focused on portal venous thrombosis and cirrhosis, and Dr. Olit Selvan started today's talk by telling us about the different grades of portal venous thrombosis and anticoagulation options open. Obviously, the discussions are predominantly geared around how which option would be suitable for patients who are on a transplant list and who are not on a transplant list, and how a peri and a post-transplant situation would be managed. One important point there was about understanding the dosage for DOACs in patients with advanced liver disease, because that's something that is something that might often get neglected in patients that are managing with PVT in these situations. Dr. Rohit presented a very nice overview about the role of TIPS and portal venous recanalization as well as thrombolysis in patients with PVT, and he raised that very important question about acute versus acute and chronic PVT, as well as giving some insight into which patients would benefit from recanalization and TIPS. Some of the data that he presented was excellent about because it showed that long-term results and recanalization patency can be obtained in patients in a carefully selected group. So that is an encouraging piece of news for hepatologists, IR people, and people who manage liver disease. Dr. Vivek obviously rounded off the extremely challenging situation of how one would manage an inflow problem when it comes to PVT in the situation of transplantation. And I think his talk is doubly appreciable for the fact that he's talking from an LDLT setting where we often do not have the options of cadaveric vein available. So there are certainly a lot of tips and tricks that he's passed on, and he presented some of his own data from a very large data set. That's excellent. That actually are I mean, those are excellent results and should actually be a benchmark for all of us. Vivek, I'm not going to lose this opportunity. I'm going to say that you must enter all that data into the ILTR
I
so
will.
that
We have started. We have started. We have started.
Yeah. So that we maintain and we set the
Of
standard
course.
for the rest
Of
of the world
course.
as well.
Of course. Of course.
Okay. And there's a question from Nashif, which says that any alternative to the usual portal venous clamp to avoid venous wall damage. I think this was because of your point about
Yeah.
the thin-walled collaterals, right? So
Yeah.
any suggestions
So
about that?
yeah, there are two things. I think once you suspect there is a portal vein thrombosis, the normally we put a clamp completely closed. So I will just put it partially closed till the time the blood flow stops. I think that is very important, number one. Number two, you can pass a sling around it and tighten it. So that is another way you can do it, and that will be less damaging as compared to putting a hard clamp on that.
Okay, that's excellent. Thank you so much for that. I think that before closing this, we'd like to pass the floor to our sponsors for a few messages, because without their help, this would not be possible. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Sonal. I'm Sandeepan Mandal from MPO Pharmaceuticals, and I thank all the faculty members and all the attendees who had come here today by taking their time from their busy schedules. We understand that these are very hard times on the medical fraternity with the COVID going on, and still everybody has taken their time out and has come here. At MPO Pharmaceuticals, it is our endeavor to provide you with the best of scientific services, as well as having a very patient-centric approaches for the patients being treated by you. So we wish with this, I wish you all a very good night, and we will soon see you all for the third virtual session of Frontiers in Liver Disease 2020 in the month of September. Thank you all and have a good day.
Okay.
Thank you. Good night. Bye.
Thank you, Sonal.